from the center of the connector out to the outer edge. Again, it's 1 5/16 of an inch. And we drill a hole for the hardware here, 3/8 of an inch in from the edge of it. And then the wire end is going to be about 3/16 of an inch from the edge of the connector. So if I take the 1 5/16 inch length and deduct 3/16 of an inch, that leaves 1 1/8 of an inch from the center to the end of that wire right there. So I'm going to deduct 1 1/8 inch from the original 3 feet 2 11/16 on that side. And then whenever I do the PVC pipe, the 3/4 inch PVC pipe, I'm going to have to notch out, put a notch in one end of it, and the notch is going to have to be at least 1/4 of an inch wide and at least 1/2 inch long. This fits inside of this connector approximately 9/16 of an inch, and so if I notch out 1/2 inch, it leaves me 1/16 of an inch right there, so that would just kind of barely cover the hole. And I have to remember that I'm putting this ring connector in here, and the ring connector will be in here something like this, and I've got to make sure that there's room for the entire body of the ring connector. If I measure 3/8 of an inch from the edge, it puts me right inside this little ring, this little marking that's already on this PVC pipe connector. So it's going to be about right in there. And it's about, looks like the other side is the same, 3/8 of an inch. It's going to put me right in about here. I'm going to go ahead and take an awl, see if I can mark this with that. It started where it needs to be. Now I'm using a 9/64 inch drill bit, and that's what I need for the number 6 hardware. Try to get this straight. So instead of having to drill 4 holes in the side of it and notching it all out, you know, widening it so I can get the ring connector through there, this is going to be a lot simpler and easier. So there's just, that's it for this connector, those 2 holes right there. The next thing I'll do is I'll get the PVC pipe marked and notched out. The notch in the PVC pipe needs to be at least 1/2 inch long, 1/4 of an inch wide. I think I'm going to mark this at 3/8 of an inch and drill a hole. I think I'll put a drill a 1/4 inch hole, 3/8 of an inch from the end, and that should get me a distance of about 1/2 inch. Alright, let's see if I can do this here. Alright, there's the hole. Put the safety glasses on first here. Should have did that first. Take the Dremel tool and a fiberglass reinforced cutoff wheel. Thank you. And there it is. Started. Come down 3/8 of an inch. Mark. Looks good.